If you've been using Excel for any period of time, I'm sure you've come across the problem of circular references. And certainly in financial models, if you're building financial statements, having circularity in your financial statements is a really common problem. So for example, you've got your P&L, of course, you've got your profit, which then drives your cash. The cash that you have is going to drive the debt or the amount of funding that you're going to need. And your debt drives your interest drives your profit. So the interest is an input to the P&L drives your profit, the profit drives your cash, and you end up with a circular reference. And that's a really common problem. If you are sitting the FMI exam that's coming up in October of this year and again in April next year, then you'll have to deal with that problem when you're building your financial model, and it's something that we often have to deal with it. So I thought I'd take you through a couple of different options as to how to get around this problem. Firstly, you can get around it mathematically. I mean, that's ideal, that you create some sort of a working line to get around the problem of a circular reference. With financial statements, it's very rare that that is going to work. So what I often do, if you have your financial statements that are on a monthly basis, you can actually have your interest calculation based on the cash balance of the prior month. That's not entirely accurate, but it is. It certainly is going to get around that problem. And if you have your cash flow is fairly regular, it's not going to make a huge amount of difference. So that's one way of doing it. If you're sitting the exam, you'll have to choose either one of these options, which is either to do the calculation based on the average balance of cash. So you look at the opening balance and the closing balance and base it on the average amount. And then you do the calculation and you need to paste value. So you basically need to hard code it in a separate row. And then we recalculate that. So every time you run a scenario, you have to recalculate it using a macro. That's probably my preferred solution. Of course, a macro is usually not the ideal solution, but it is going to get around that problem. Lastly, if you are really, really short of time and you just need to get it done, for example, if you're in the exam, then you might decide to enable iterative calculations. I personally would never do that in the real world, but it is an option. So those are the couple of ways that you can get around the problem of circularity in financial models.